Rides Percussion.
Stuck inside of the wrong frame. I don't feel attached to this name. My body, I must reclaim. With different eyes and no shame.
I definitely did not think I was good enough when I tried out my first time. I looked around and I think all four quads said that they were returning that year.
And it was like the first season of indoor drumline I'd actually ever marched. I had like no idea what anything was. I was like, I'm just kind of here. I want to get better. I like drums, so.
I was so scared. I spent all of the time I possibly had practicing green scales just so I could get perfect at green scales in case I messed up on something else.
And I was like, I'm not gonna make this line. I've never drummed on like a real line before.
So I first tried out for Rise for the snare line. I didn't make it. Then I went down to the front ensemble room and turns out I got a spot on rack, and that's where I've been ever since.
I first auditioned in 2013. I was 16 years old and I tried out on bass, and I'd never played bass before in my entire life, and so I got cut.
I didn't think I was going to make it. I was positive that I was not good enough, but I ended up making it.
It was the first audition where I actually like had a chance of making a spot, so I was really, really nervous, but it went well, I guess.
And then they were like, oh, you should go over to the cymbal room. And I was like, okay. And I held my cymbals at set for like 2 seconds, and it hurt so bad. And I did not think I was going to be able to like get through the day.
You know, sometimes you can be surprised and end up in a place you didn't expect. And that becomes what you want to do for the rest of your time here.
I was so scared that I wouldn't make it, but I'm really happy that I did. And now it's going to be my fourth year coming to auditions, so it's exciting.
And at the end of the day, I like got through it and I finished it, and I was like, oh, this is actually pretty cool, like being able to push myself super duper hard and then like still be okay at the end of the day. So that's kind of why I stuck with it, and now I'm getting better every year.
There's just so much that goes into it that makes it what it is and helps make the show this like next level thing, but it just adds a bunch of different layers to what you have to do. It's not just playing your part, it's playing your part and knowing how to run all of the electronics.
A couple years ago, they had a tundrum feature during the ballad portion, and then last year we played on kalimbas during our fourth movement, and that's a really unique part of Rise, is that we incorporate other instruments and it's not just completely mallet-centered.
Our music is actually treated as vibraphone music, which is unfortunately not super common in the marching world. We get very lyrical things, and we also use Burton grip.
A lot of like what we do is just based on like, hey, I made up this really cool thing after school the other day, and I think we should do it. And then we all like try to learn it, and we teach ourselves. And so it's kind of nice having like everybody come together to teach one another.
Every year we've always had like a really solid dynamic between the five of us. Like, it's always been like five of my best friends ever that I've marched with, which is pretty cool.
It's all about the family vibe, just showing up, feeling like you're drumming with your friends, not just, you know, showing up to rehearsal.
We always just vibe together. We have a really good time playing. That was just the best part of my year last year, was going to Rise rehearsal and having sectionals with the Marimba line. Those are my best friends.
I've never been a part of a line in my entire life that has been so close-knit and so together all the time. Like, such a family, and I love it.
It always ends up a different show at the end of the season than when we start. But I think we're better off now than we ever have been. On the edge.